Almost every Fortnite player is affected by this problem, and this is the reason they aren't improving as fast as others. Avoiding bad mentalities, guys, is something most players fail to do, and chances are you might be one of them. So having a bad mentality when playing Fortnite is one of the biggest factors that keeps players from improving. Butcher Crunch Army, where you at? Your motivation guy is back. That's right, I'm here for you guys. Keith Allen, man. How you guys doing? Wish you guys the best year yet. So today, I'm going to be showing you guys some dangerous mentalities that really decrease the level of skill that you play and grow at. You guys got to stick around for the entire video because I'm going to show you how to counter them. Speaking of which, all right, our question of the day, here we go. What is the one thing that you wish you could improve at? Let me know in the comments, all right? All right, let's get this thing going. Here we go. First up, blaming your teammates when competing or simply just practicing against others, right? Like, obviously, team modes are about depending on your team, but playing your part is crucial for your team to succeed. Every time that you feel that you can't find good teammates, guys, like, work on yourself. You can never go wrong there, all right? Work on yourself. You can always improve, right? And by the time you continually work on yourself, you're going to be attracting the right players. So in Fortnite, looking for teammates is very placement-based. Like, every single competitive player is ranked based on their power rankings and earnings. And solos are the best way to improve your skill. So you guys got to utilize pro guys, man, to get better at every skill imaginable. And after you work on yourself, finding a teammate, it's going to be a piece of cake. Okay, so another way to help shape how your team plays and recovers is being positive. I'm your motivation guy, and that's what it's all about, man. Bunch of crunch, Charmin. That's what we do, man. We're leaders, all right? We inspire others to be great. Even when we're down, man, we look to cheer someone else up. Because at the end of the day, when you put a smile on someone else's face, guess what, man? You can't help but to smile yourself, right? And that's what a leader does. And everything that you can do to keep the team going is what it's really all about. Criticism is very helpful, but make sure that you come off in a positive way. You know, you want to keep that constructive, right? And you can just be able to keep everybody calm and motivated. So try to be the best teammate that you can possibly be and really just set everybody up for success, not just for yourself. Just remember that teamwork and synergy is the key to success in competitive modes. So you got to do your best to hold your team together, all right? You be the glue, all right? You got to do that. So analyzing what you and your teammates did wrong is very helpful, but just don't get stuck on it or you're going to lose both control of your gameplay and your team. It's going to start falling apart. You just got to make sure that you focus on yourself first and you don't have to feel like you always have to control others. All right, real quick, guys, make sure you got to check out Clix's new master course right now on ProGuys.com. Like, not like right now, but like after this video. We also have pro coaches tailored to help you improve quickly. So you got to click the link below or top right to get started today. Okay, so although many of you guys may not be able to control this, blaming factors outside of the game that cause failures, such as like game servers or your gaming setup, it's a mentality that you need to really get rid of. Like, a big thing about wanting to succeed in Fortnite, but having problems that go against it, it's really finding a solution no matter what obstacle gets in the way. I always tell you guys, when you hit me up on my Insta, at Your Motivation Guy, you already know, you can only control what you can control. Everything else, man, you just kind of got to leave it up in the air. So a lot of professional players have started on worse setups imaginable, but they kept grinding every single day and eventually found solutions to overcome this problem. So a great example of a professional player who started off with a low-end setup is NRG Unknown. He started playing Fortnite on a console and couldn't switch to PC no matter how hard he tried to convince his parents. And finally, he played many different small tournaments and wagers and used his hard work to buy himself a nice PC, which he later ended up qualifying for the World Cup on. So to recap this mentality, just remember that when you feel that you can't do anything about your setup, just remember, guys, there is always a solution. Remember that. So a huge factor in succeeding in the Fortnite competitive world is your luck, and getting enough resources like loot and mobility is an essential way to determine your game's outcome. So saying that you're a player that has like bad luck is a very bad mentality that you really need to stay away from. And there is always a solution for this. So many players use this as an excuse to why they aren't succeeding in placing in tournaments. And you might be one of them. Sure, RNG is definitely a big factor, but it applies to everybody, like not just a select few. So the reason professional players are so consistent, guys, is because they really know every nook and cranny of their drop spots. And sticking to the same spot for the entire season is definitely a really good thing to do. The luck factor will be with you, like, no matter what game you play. So you gotta make sure you know exactly what to do to counter being unlucky, and definitely try to find a spot that gives you a head start. All right, bunch of crunch army, hope you guys still here, man. I want to encourage you guys, man, to keep grinding. Like, really don't stop. no matter what. Like, I know some of you guys deal with lack of support, even from family or friends or, you know, whatever. But I just want to tell you, like, if you don't believe in yourself, nobody will. All right, guys, keep this going. So another huge part of Fortnite is not only how efficiently you fight, but it's also your mental game. Like, staying motivated throughout the entire tournament is key, and really only takes one big game to really change your entire tournament. For example, dying off spawn two games in a row is fine in 10 match formats, as you could just freely play your next game and just really make it a big one. So staying positive and knowing that anything can happen is a great way of staying motivated. And just remember this, guys, like, it's not over yet, right? Refrain from saying things like, I'm done playing, or I suck. Because once you believe it's over, and once you really believe that you suck or you're trash, how are you gonna get better? So having a big ego is like a huge problem when trying to improve in Fortnite. Like, if you believe that you have nothing to improve on, then there's really no point even practicing the game. Having an ego causes procrastination, and it can really mess you up when you're looking for a team to play tournaments with. So if you decline every player you see just because you think that they aren't up to your level, you aren't going to really get any progress towards getting better and succeeding, all right? Having confidence is really good, but thinking you're just like automatically the best could really cost you in a lot of ways. Just make sure that you get that out of your head and realize that the things pros have to do to maintain their skill level. All right, guys, so to recap this video, make sure to avoid these mentalities and keep a positive mindset that's going to allow you to push forward no matter what obstacles come in your way. A huge part of Fortnite is all about your mental game, guys. Mental game. And it's really a test of patience and determination. Like, how bad do you want it? I'm asking you right now, as your motivation guy, like, how bad do you want it, man? How bad do you want to succeed, not only in this game, but also in life? That when you come against a wall or an obstacle and things get hard, like, I understand. I've been there. You know, life is hard. But you know what? Winners get up. Winners don't quit. Winners keep going. You're a winner, man. Keep going. You're going to keep improving and utilizing pro guides. Speaking of which, you can always check out the rest of our channel for more tips and tricks. And if you guys found this video helpful, make sure to like the video, and you can always sub with the bell button on for more, man. When we get 1 million followers, guess what? When we get 1 million subscribers, we are releasing my own story of how your motivation guy made it to where I'm at today. I can't wait to tell you guys. I can't wait to show you guys. I hope it inspires you to keep going and really just to go after your dreams. All right, guys, until the next one, we'll see you soon. Peace.